Dear future enthusiasts and time travel daydreamers, ever wonder what humanity might look like in a few centuries? Well, strap in, because we're about to take a wild ride through the next 400 years of human history. And let me tell you, it's going to be one heck of a journey. Let's kick things off with the next century. Imagine this. It's 2124, and your great-great-grandkids are casually chatting with their AI besties while their self-driving flying cars zip through the skylines of massive gleaming cities. Sounds like science fiction, right? Well, hold on to your hoverboards, because that's just the tip of the iceberg. In the next 100 years, we're likely to see artificial intelligence become as commonplace as smartphones are today. But we're not talking about Siri's slightly smarter cousin here. We're talking about AI that can write symphonies, solve complex scientific problems, and maybe even become your new BFF. The job market? Oh boy, it's going to look about as familiar as a floppy disk to a Gen Z kid. But don't worry, we won't all be replaced by robots. Instead, we'll probably see a shift towards jobs that require uniquely human skills like creativity, empathy, and coming up with new TikTok dance challenges. Okay, maybe not that last one, but you get the idea. Now, let's talk space. In 100 years, we might be booking our summer vacations to the moon instead of the Maldives. That's right, lunar bases could be a thing. And Mars, well, let's just say Elon Musk's great-grandkids might be running SpaceX franchises on the red planet. We're not just talking about a few brave astronauts either. We could be looking at full-blown colonies with people living, working, and maybe even starting the first interplanetary soccer league. But it's not all sci-fi coolness and space adventures. We've got some serious challenges heading our way. And I'm not just talking about figuring out how to get pizza delivered to Mars. Climate change is going to be a big deal. And in the next century, we'll likely see some major shifts in how we live to adapt to our changing planet. Imagine cities that can literally rise with sea levels, buildings that eat smog for breakfast, and vertical farms that make skyscrapers look like cute little bungalows. We might even see the emergence of entire floating cities. Venice, eat your heart out. And speaking of eating, our diets might look a bit different too. Lab-grown meat could be the new organic, and those plant-based burgers, they might taste so good that even your carnivore uncle can't tell the difference. We might even be munching on insects for protein. Crispy cricket chips, anyone? Now, let's talk about you, or rather, the future you. Medicine is set to take some giant leaps in the next 100 years. We're talking personalized treatments based on your unique genetic code, nanobots swimming around in your bloodstream zapping diseases, and 3D printed organs that make transplant waiting lists a thing of the past. But it's not just about fixing what's broken. We might be looking at the early stages of human augmentation. Brain-computer interfaces could turn you into a walking, talking Wikipedia, but hopefully with better citations. And genetic engineering? It could be as common as getting braces. Want blue hair? Don't dye it, just tweak your genes. Of course, all this change is going to have some pretty big impacts on how we live and interact with each other. Cities are likely to get bigger, smarter, and possibly a lot weirder. Imagine buildings that change shape based on the weather, roads that charge your electric car as you drive, and parks that double as urban farms. And forget about learning a second language. With real-time translation technology, you could be chatting with someone from Tokyo as easily as if they live next door. The internet? It might be so integrated into our daily lives that the line between online and offline becomes as blurry as your vision after binge-watching an entire season of your favorite show. But here's the million-dollar question. With all this incredible technology at our fingertips, will we be happier? Will we have solved big problems like inequality and hunger, or will we just have shinier toys to distract us? The truth is, technology is just a tool. It's up to us to decide how to use it. In the next 100 years, we'll face some big decisions about how we want to shape our future. Do we use genetic engineering to eliminate diseases or to create designer babies? Do we use AI to solve global problems or to create even more convincing deepfakes? If you think the first 100 years are already crazy, The next 100 is going to be straight out of science fiction. Time travelers, let's crank up our flux capacitors and zoom ahead another century. We're now stepping into the world of 2224. Remember those baby steps we were taking into genetic engineering? Well, in this century, we're not just walking, we're running a genetic marathon. CRISPR technology, which was just starting to make waves back in our day, has now become as commonplace as smartphones were to us. Imagine walking down the street and seeing people with bioluminescent skin glowing softly in the dark. No, it's not a rave party gone wrong, it's just the latest fashion trend. Want eyes that can see in infrared? Or maybe you fancy having chlorophyll in your skin so you can photosynthesize like a plant? In 2224, that might be as simple as a trip to your local gene-tweaking salon. But it's not all about looking cool. Although, let's be honest, photosynthesizing would be pretty awesome. These genetic modifications could lead to humans who are more resistant to diseases, can survive in harsh environments, or even live significantly longer. We might be looking at the first generation of humans routinely living to 150 or beyond. Midlife crisis at 75, anyone? Now, let's talk space. Remember how we mentioned moon vacations and Mars colonies? Well, buckle up, Buttercup, because in 2224, that's old news. We're talking about permanent settlements on Mars, mining operations on asteroids, and maybe even the first human footprints on the moons of Jupiter or Saturn. Imagine waking up to the red Martian sunrise, hopping on your low-gravity transport to your job at the local terraforming plant, and then ending your day by video calling your grandkids back on Earth. Just don't forget the 20-minute delay in communications. Interplanetary lag is a real pain. But it's not just about colonizing our solar system. By this point, we might be seriously looking at interstellar travel. Remember that scene in 2001 A Space Odyssey with the rotating space station? We might have massive ships like that, but designed for long-term, multi-generational voyages to other star systems. Your great-great-great-grandkids could be the first humans to set foot on an exoplanet. Back on Earth, assuming we haven't renamed it Old Terra or something equally dramatic by this point, things are looking pretty different too. Those smart cities we talked about in the last century? They've evolved into something that would make the Jetsons look positively Stone Age. Think cities that can reconfigure themselves based on the needs of their inhabitants, buildings that can move and change shape, roads that can shift to accommodate traffic patterns, and public spaces that transform from parks during the day to open-air theaters at night. And all of this managed by hyper-advanced AI systems that make our current smart assistants look like pocket calculators. Speaking of AI, by 2224, the line between human and artificial intelligence might be getting pretty blurry. We could be looking at the emergence of transhumanism, the idea of using technology to enhance human, physical, and cognitive abilities. Brain-computer interfaces might allow us to access the sum of human knowledge with a thought, or to control machines with our minds. But here's where it really gets wild. We might be seeing the first signs of what some futurists call the technological singularity. A point where artificial intelligence becomes so advanced that it surpasses human intelligence and starts improving itself at an exponential rate. If that happens, all bets are off on what the world might look like. Now you might be thinking, but what about all those problems we had back in the 21st century? Climate change, inequality, political divisions? Well, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is that with all this advanced technology, we've probably made some serious progress on these issues. Climate change? We might have massive atmospheric scrubbers cleaning the air or even be able to control the weather on a global scale. Inequality? With advanced AI and automation, we could be looking at a post-scarcity society where everyone's basic needs are met. The bad news? Well, humans being humans, we've probably found whole new problems to argue about. Should we allow unrestricted genetic modifications of humans? What rights should AI have? Is it ethical to terraform other planets if there's a chance of indigenous microbial life? These are the kinds of debates that might be raging in 2224. And let's not forget about culture and society. With people potentially living for 150 years or more, our whole concept of life stages might have to be rethought. Maybe you spent your first 50 years in education, the next 50 building a career, and then start a whole new life at 100. Language could be wildly different too. With instant translation technology and global connectivity, we might see the emergence of a true global language. Or maybe we'll all be communicating in emoji and memes by then. Art and entertainment? Hold on to your VR headsets. We might have fully immersive experiences where you can step into your favorite movie or game. Or how about dream recording technology that lets you share your nighttime adventures with friends? Netflix and chill could take on a whole new meaning. But perhaps the biggest challenge by 2224 might be in how we see ourselves as a species. With colonies on other planets, regular interaction with AI, and the ability to fundamentally alter our own biology, the question of what does it mean to be human is going to be more complex than ever. Are we still human if we can photosynthesize? If our minds can connect directly to the internet? If we can live for centuries? These are the kinds of philosophical questions that the people of 2224 might be grappling with. And yet, for all these mind-bending changes, some things might remain surprisingly familiar. People will still fall in love, have their hearts broken, celebrate victories, and mourn losses. We'll still look up at the stars with wonder, even if those stars are a lot closer than they used to be. Because no matter how far we advance technologically, at our core we're still human. And that humanity, with all its flaws, quirks, and incredible potential, is what will carry us forward into the next century and beyond. Moving on to the next 100 years. We've blasted past the year 2324 and we're hurtling towards the 25th century. Buckle up, because things are about to get seriously wild. By this point, the world, or should I say worlds, we're living in might be almost unrecognizable to our 21st century eyes. We're not just talking about humans anymore, we're talking about humanity in all its diverse, augmented, and possibly digital forms. Let's start with the big one, artificial superintelligence. Remember how we mentioned the technological singularity back in the 22nd century? Well, by now it's likely happened. We might be sharing our solar system with intelligences that are, to us, what we are to ants. Imagine entities that can think a million times faster than us, that can solve problems we can't even comprehend. These superintelligent AIs might not be separate from us. Through brain-computer interfaces and other technologies, we might have merged with AI to become something entirely new. Imagine having the ability to think in multiple dimensions, to process information at the speed of light, to experience realities beyond our current comprehension. And speaking of realities, the line between the physical and digital worlds might be completely blurred by this point. Virtual and augmented reality could be so advanced that the difference between real and simulated experiences is meaningless. You could spend years in simulated worlds, learning, creating, and exploring, and it would be just as valid as any physical experience. Let's talk about that physical world for a moment. Earth, our old blue marble, might look pretty different by now. Thanks to advanced climate engineering and ecological restoration technologies, we might have reversed the damage done by climate change. Imagine vast swaths of restored rainforest, thriving coral reefs, and the return of species long thought extinct. Cities? They might be vertical forests of self-sustaining arcologies, or they might have moved underground or underwater to free up the surface for nature. Or maybe we've gone the other way, with most of humanity living in orbital habitats, leaving Earth as a protected nature preserve. And that's just Earth. By the 25th century, humanity, or whatever we've become, might have spread throughout the solar system and beyond. Colonies on Mars, Europa, and Titan might be old news. We could be mining the asteroid belt, harvesting the atmospheres of gas giants, or even beginning to re-engineer entire planets. Interstellar travel? It might be commonplace by now. Perhaps we've developed faster-than-light travel, or maybe we're sending out fleets of self-replicating probes to explore and potentially colonize other star systems. We might even be in contact with alien civilizations, completely reshaping our understanding of our place in the universe. But let's zoom in a bit and talk about individual humans, if that term still applies. By the 25th century, the human body might be seen as infinitely malleable. Want to breathe underwater? Grow some gills. Want to explore the methane seas of Titan? Redesign your body to thrive in cryogenic temperatures. The human form could be seen as just another technology to be upgraded and customized at will. And death? It might be optional. Between radical life extension technologies, mind uploading, and the ability to grow new bodies, the concept of a natural lifespan might be as outdated as dial-up internet. Imagine beings who have lived for centuries, accumulating knowledge and experiences beyond our comprehension. But with all these mind-bending possibilities come equally profound questions. If we can live forever, edit our memories, and experience countless simulated lives, what does that mean for our sense of self? If we can reshape our bodies and minds at will, what does it mean to be human? And let's not forget about society and culture. With potentially infinite lifespans and the ability to experience multiple realities, how would we organize ourselves? The concepts of nations, economies, and even families might have evolved into forms we can barely imagine. Maybe we've developed new forms of governance based on real-time collective decision-making, enabled by brain-to-brain communication networks. Or perhaps we've split into countless subspecies and cultures, each adapted to different environments and ways of life, from digital realms to the depths of gas giant atmospheres. Art and creativity might have taken on entirely new dimensions. Imagine symphonies composed in scent, sculptures that exist in 11 dimensions, or stories that you don't just read or watch, but fully experience from multiple perspectives simultaneously. Science and technology would be advancing at a pace that would make our current rate of progress look glacial. We might be unraveling the fundamental nature of reality, harnessing the energy of black holes, or even creating new universes in laboratory conditions. But amidst all this change and advancement, we might find ourselves grappling with some very familiar questions. What is the nature of consciousness? What is our purpose in this vast universe? Are we alone? Or are there other intelligences out there among the stars? And perhaps the biggest question of all, with all this power and knowledge at our fingertips, what do we do next? Do we continue to expand outward, seeding the galaxy with life? Do we turn inward, exploring the infinite realms of simulated realities and our own consciousness? Or do we strive for something even grander, becoming the guardians and cultivators of life throughout the universe? The truth is, trying to predict what humanity will be like in 400 years is like a caveman trying to imagine the internet. We're limited by our current understanding, our current problems, and our current dreams. The reality could be far stranger, far more wonderful, or far more challenging than anything we can imagine. But that's the beauty of it, isn't it? The future isn't set in stone. It's a vast, uncharted territory waiting to be explored and shaped. And while we might not live to see the 25th century ourselves, every choice we make today, every problem we solve, every dream we pursue helps to shape that future. We may not be able to imagine precisely what it's going to be like in 1,000 years with AI, but what I do know is that I had fun making this video for you. Click the like button if you want more of these, and hit subscribe so you don't miss out on every single video we release. Until next time, stay insanely curious.